Yep, it's finally here. The all-new 2022 GMC Hummer EV pickup truck. The Hummer is back, but now it's this all-electric pickup truck. I know it's pretty weird, but this is the world debut, so I'm gonna show you all the specifications, all the images, all the data, all the insider information that we have about this truck, and we have a lot. This video, I'm gonna go over all the specs. Also, I'm gonna show you little clips from interviews I've done with the chief designer of the GMC Hummer, Rich Scheer, and the engineer, Todd Hubbard, who's on the team, who actually designs and builds this new GMC Hummer. And if you wanna know more about those interviews, you can also, after this video, go to TFL Talk, which is our podcast channel. You can get a deep dive into everything about this truck from the people who actually created it. But let's get going with powertrain. Yes, it's all electric, battery powered truck. And what they're doing here is they're introducing it in its most optioned high performance configuration first. They're calling it Edition 1. And the Edition 1 of the Hummer EV truck is going to be available basically in one color. It's going to be this white color with kind of blacked out trim and a very fancy interior as well. And it's gonna have three electric motors. Total horsepower, as you've seen before, 1,000 horsepower, 11,500 pound-feet of torque, and this is grounded torque, basically multiplied through the gearing to the ground. And a lot of manufacturers like Rivian and others are beginning to quote these grounded torque figures, which sound kind of ridiculous, but this is what we have. This is the information we're presenting to you from the manufacturer. And this truck will be capable of a 0 to 60 miles per hour run in 3 seconds. Yes, it's targeting the Tesla Cybertruck, the highest performance electric trucks that have been so far announced, although none of them actually are for sale yet. But the Hummer EV truck will go on sale, according to GMC and GM, at the end of 2021, or in the fall of 2021. And here is Todd Hubbard, like I said, one of the engineers on this truck, explaining exactly how this behemoth, pretty heavy and big vehicle, can achieve a 3 second 0 to 60 using what they call watts to freedom mode, which is a very fancy marketing term. Let's find out more.
There's a mode called watts to freedom that you enter, mm-hmm. and the sound system, the user interface, it's all preparing you almost like a roller coaster ride for this awesome acceleration. So we're conditioning the electronics. We lower the vehicle 2 inches to get the CG lower. And all this is happening with this incredible buildup of sight and sound. You put your foot on the brake, you put your foot on the gas, you release your foot from the brake, and it takes off like a rocket. So it's like I said, I love the off-road performance, but it's a no compromise from every attribute of the vehicle, including on-road performance. So
yeah, that's pretty cool. The whole vehicle is supposed to just kind of hunker down. It's supposed to give you visual cues on the inside and actually accelerate in a huge, fast way. I can't wait to experience this. But we have to talk about the design, right? This is very important. This is a halo truck for General Motors. They're not saying that outright, but they are calling it the first super truck. And for them, it's going up against everything from the Ford Raptor, the new Ram TRX, to all the electric trucks that are also coming to the market within the next 1 or 2 years. And this is all of their technology packed into one. Just mind-boggling. Sorry, I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself here because this truck has so much. And at the end of this video, I'm also gonna tell you the price. But let's talk about design a little bit. It's a crew cab with a short bed, about 5 foot box. It's a unibody on chassis design. So kind of, they call it integral body on frame. And the frame, of course, is the skateboard chassis that also contains the batteries. So it's a little bit of a different configuration. But here's the chief designer, Rich Scheer, to explain kind of the vision and also the sizing of this truck and what they were going for when they were actually designing and building the new Hummer.
The dimensions we kind of created on the fly, right? So the brand, the architecture, the what, all came about at the same time. You know, we had very simple seating platforms to try to figure out how to arrange occupants, where they fit on the wheelbase. It's a 5-foot bed, so it's got a little bit shorter bed than most pickup trucks, right? And then when you kind of walk around 3/4 view in front, now you're going to get to see track that, oh my gosh, you know, when I was back working on Silverado, I would have loved, right? So it's got 3 inches of side plush track. So it's really like face of tires, much like a Raptor, right? Raptor pulls the track way out, the body's sucked in, and that really gives you a great stance, lots of great capability. It plants the vehicle, gives the body a lot of drama from door surface out to tire surface. So again, it's like, if you kind of think about AT4 or Raptor, it fits within that envelope.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Part of it is, of course, the removable roof. They have the panels that stow in the front storage area, the front trunk. And they have other features like the powered tonneau cover. And I can see they're also targeting manufacturers like Tesla. When the Cybertruck was unveiled, of course, it had all the kind of crazy specs, but it also had a power retractable tonneau cover. And it seems like, you know, General Motors was kind of looking at that and seeing how they could incorporate all of those design elements into one. And it's also interesting that there is not really a cut or a break between the cab, the four-door cab, and the bed. So it's kind of like a one sheet design on the side. And it's actually like an Avalanche, like an old Avalanche. And this is, it kind of matches to the rumors we've heard months ago. So that's pretty interesting. I didn't quite expect that to be true. So let's talk about the batteries that power this beast. We know how quick it is, but how far can it go? General Motors GMC is estimating at least 350 miles of range on this battery pack. They call it the Ultium. It's their latest design for the batteries, latest chemistry. It's still lithium ion, but it has different chemistry involved with it, with a little bit more aluminum, a little bit less cobalt. So they're trying to be make it as environmentally friendly as possible, and also, of course, be as usable as possible for maximum range, acceleration, so forth. This system is 800 volt capable for direct current DC charging. The size of the battery is up to 200 kilowatt hours. And they actually didn't have this number in their spec sheet. This is what I'm estimating based on the total, all the information we have so far. They call it 24 Ultium modules. So these modules are built in to the battery and they're kind of stacked on top of each other inside the frame of the thing. 350 kilowatt charging is possible, they say. If the charger can support it, so can the Hummer EV, which means it's almost or is one of the fastest charging electric vehicles to date, as announced. Of course, it's not for sale quite yet. It's going to be there in about a year. And they say it can gain about 100 miles of range in about 10 minutes. Of course, it depends on the charging network, the state of the battery. And 350 miles is decent, but it's a little bit less than some of the other competitors are claiming, like 400 miles plus from the Rivian and something crazy like 500 miles from the Tesla. So we'll have to see how that shakes out when these vehicles actually go on sale. All right, let's focus on the interior a little bit more. This is a very high-end interior. The designers tell me they were kind of trying to bring futuristic look to the present. And they also told me, Rich told me, that it's almost like, it's kind of like a lunar buggy. If you put this Hummer on the moon, it would kind of look at home. It's very high tech. Obviously, there's a huge screen, 13.4-inch main infotainment screen, and there's a 12.3-inch digital cluster. There's still cup holders. There's still, you know, comfortable seats. All of that is there. I can't wait, actually, to get in the thing and actually see it. But it's full of technology, and it's interesting that they're announcing a larger screen, 13.4. It's bigger than what the latest Ford F-150 trucks have. It's bigger than the current Ram 1500s have. So they're kind of targeting that premium segment, really, really nice, luxurious, and sporty interior. Also, up to 18 camera views that you can access through that screen. Yes, 18 camera views. There are two cameras underneath the vehicle, and Todd Hubbard told me about this, that there's one pointing forward under the front axles and one pointing backwards in the rear. So if you're traversing obstacles, you could switch to those cameras if you're moving slowly off-road and actually check out what's in front of you, which is new. It's, you know, industry exclusive so far, which is pretty cool. So let's move on quickly to chassis and shocks. Like I told you already, it's a skateboard platform, four-corner independent suspension, air springs, so air suspension, up to 16 inches of ground clearance. Yes, 16 inches maximum ground clearance in something they call extract mode, which I'll get to in a second. Four-wheel steering, skid plates, virtual lockers, based on this tri-motor system, triple motor system. And the shocks are ZF-CDC. So yes, ZF or ZF, you may have heard of ZF based on their transmissions in trucks. Well, they also make suspensions, shocks, they make rear steering systems. So, and they're actually supplying the shocks, active shocks for the Hummer EV. 35 inch tall tires and up to, or just over 24 inches of water fording. Not a lot of water fording capability. I think it probably has to do with the actual batteries inside the frame, but still it's pretty decent. And here's Rich to tell us more about the tires and capability for the tires.
The tires are 35s, right? So, you know, on our new light duty GM trucks, they're 33s. These are 35s. The cool part, and I know all your fans on your website will love, is that we architected the vehicle to 37s. So if a customer's really interested in, and they're true hardcore off-roaders and they want to do those sorts of things, you can throw 37s on it. And you're not beating fenders and you're not doing any of that. You're not cutting the vehicle. It fits.
Yes, 37-inch tall tires are, you know, the new 34-inch tall tires. Everybody's going for bigger sizes. And I'm actually happy to know that the new Hummer EV is actually able to accept that size of tire. We don't have weight ratings, payload, or towing numbers for this truck yet. I asked Todd this question, and he said the ratings are not finalized yet. But I do see that the wheels have 8 lugs, which makes me think this is more of a heavy-duty truck, maybe like a 3/4 ton rather than a half-ton truck. And Todd told me that I'm on the right path. Just exact numbers are not known or not available yet. We don't know about towing range. They didn't talk about that. So those numbers are still to come. It has several modes. I already mentioned the extract mode. Basically, the air suspension can lift all the way up to about 16 inches of ground clearance and help you traverse obstacles. Obviously, you're using a lot of the suspension travel, so it'll be very, very stiff in that maximum clearance. But at least it should be able to let you get over a hard obstacle and actually keep moving. But the active shocks, first of all, they're monitoring what's happening with the truck constantly. And then also they can be, you know, the driver select, you can tell it exactly what you want. It could be anything from comfortable on-road driving to terrain for slow crawling. And it just adjusts the power delivery, the shocks, the air springs, everything is adjusted. There's also what they call an off-road mode, which is they're kind of like a Baja mode for fast running. So according to them, this truck is supposed to be able to, yes, go fast off-road. I mean, why not? This is the halo truck for them. And even like Rich said, you know, from the front, it has that wide stance of a Ford Raptor. So yes, they're targeting all of those competitors. And here's Todd to actually tell me about more about how they plan to test this and also take it to the Rubicon Trail.
On the Rubicon Trail, there's this part of the, it's called the Big Sluice. Uh-huh. And there's a section halfway down, there's a boulder the size of a house and there's a tree. And inevitably, you're always wedged right in the middle of this. And I can just picture now how this crab mode, you would just like, it would make it so easy. You know, we spent a lot of time there trying to get vehicles through, but I think that's a case where I'm really excited to try that feature out. So.
And you mentioned Rubicon. Are you targeting this vehicle to actually do the Rubicon, or how come you brought the Rubicon Trail in?
So yes, we are. We are looking at class four trails. So Moab, you would check off some Moab Rim, Poison Spider, Hell's Revenge, you know, the tougher trails there. And then also we definitely plan to take it to Rubicon, and we think it's going to do really well there. It's a large vehicle, but we think with the features we have, the incredible dimensions in terms of approach, departure, breakover, all the features we have, we think it's going to do quite well at Rubicon too.
Yeah, I actually want to be there when they go to Moab, Utah. It's really close to us here in Colorado, and take it to Hell's Revenge or actually the Rubicon Trail. That's going to be amazing because it's a big truck, but it's very maneuverable according to Todd because of that four-wheel steer. Not only the crab mode where it can go diagonally sideways, but also so the wheels can steer to make your turning radius very, very tight, which is really nice. Finally, yes, it has a lot of technology built in. This edition one will have Super Cruise, which is semi-autonomous mode for General Motors. It will have the latest edition of that, which means it can keep the speed. It can steer for you on about 200,000 miles of divided pre-mapped highways across the country. Yes, it has to recognize the highway before it does that, but also it should be able to change lanes. That's what Todd told me, that the latest version of Super Cruise for the Hummer will also enable it to change lanes and go on the highways. Competition, already mentioned. We need to talk a little bit about pricing. So Rivian, Cybertruck, Ram, TRX, Ford Raptor, all of those are there. The price, there's only going to be one price initially for the Hummer EV, $112,595. Yes, that's a big price. It's well over 100 grand. This is before taxes and destination charges. And they have a plan. They have a 3.5-year plan that they outlined for offering more affordable versions of the Hummer into the future. But let's look at this price. So Rivian truck R1T base price is around 70 to 75 grand. Cybertruck starting price for the tri-motor is around 60, let's say 65, maybe a little bit more plus options. Ram Rebel TRX or Ram 1500 TRX starts at 70 grand, goes to 100 grand. This truck, the Halo truck for GM, 112,000. So yes, it's above and beyond kind of all the pricing that's currently available. But in the fall of 2022, they say the price will go down to about 100 grand when you remove some of the options. In the spring of 23, the price will be down to 90,000, 89,000. And then by the spring of 24, the price will be around 80 grand. So yes, it's still a very premium truck, very expensive truck, very capable truck. And by then, of course, 3 years from now, we should have the Cybertruck on the road, the Rivian, electric F-150, maybe even electric Silverado will be available by then from Chevy. This will be built at the Detroit Hamtramck factory. I could never say that name correctly, I apologize. But they're also now renaming that factory to Factory Zero, which is their biggest, big investment, huge investment, but still Detroit, still Michigan produced. And the Factory Zero is going to be the latest electric truck capable plant for General Motors. And it's going to be available late 2021, about a year from now. So so I hope you were able to get a really good picture, really detailed picture of this truck. And if you want more, go back to TFL Talk channel, our podcast channel, where you can get a little bit more detail and actually hear a little bit more from the designers and the engineers. And go back to tfltruck.com for all the latest news, views, and real-world truck reviews.